Scoobo.
Terrible beast they are. They must munch us. Poor Bogo Scoobo. Ow, ow.
And now they know where you live.
Thank you.
Not bad. Didn't think you had it in you, to be honest. Here's your cut. Go on, take it.
What? Don't you have a chocobo to care for?
Again, you don't have a lot of friends, do you? It's okay, I'll be your friend.
Be careful not to stray. Are you taking the train? here is why. Don't forget to...
Today, the City of Light has been the scene of much tragedy. A great number of our residents have lost their lives. Let us offer prayers.
Long time no see, Vanille. You look well, and you haven't changed. You're just as I remember.
Me and everyone else. But you don't mean it like that, do you?
Vanille. We'd fought together once a long time ago. We were comrades in arms in a battle against gods who toyed with human destiny. And at the end of that battle, she sacrificed herself. She turned into a great crystal pillar, rising from the plains of Pulse, holding a world full of people safe in the sky.
But then 13 years ago, she came back.
You again?
Oh.
So you two know each other?
Oh yes, we've been together ever since I woke up.
Right, thick as thieves.
But Fang's not around.
Well, we woke up at the same time, and we were together for a while, but she left.
And you decided to stay behind under the protection of the Order? You must have a reason.
Uh-huh. There's something I have to do. It has to be me, and it has to happen right here.
There's a lot of chaos swirling around in here. I'd have thought the Order's cathedral at least would still be clear.
Yes, yes, I know. It hurts terribly. I understand. But it won't be long now. You'll be free soon.
Vanille, who are you talking to? What is this stuff?
A wind of sorrow, the lament of the dead. Can't you hear their voices? Lost souls crying out in pain and suffering.
You mean this wind is the dead?
Yeah, they've been drawn here, one after another. All the people who died after the chaos poured through the gate. They've been swallowed by the chaos, and now they're trapped inside. I can feel it. All their sadness, all their grief. They're swirling around me. Every single cry feels like a dagger. Right in my heart.
There must be so many millions of souls. And you feel all their pain? That can't be.
Our world is being destroyed. There's no place for them to come back to. And there's no way for them to be reborn anymore. So they're caught in the chaos with their pain. They just can't escape it.
The Order believes that the souls have to be saved from their sorrow. They say the only way to do that is to offer them oblivion. Vanille's job is to call them to her so that can happen.
All of those souls at the same time? But Vanille, will you be able to handle all that?
I don't have any choice.
Besides, if she doesn't, can you guess what will happen? This wind has been building for years. Layers of souls. A black hole of pain. Try and imagine how much energy is inside.
If it ever got out, all at once.
It'd be the end of this world, and the future as well.
Chaos infusion or something?
Yeah, but don't worry about it. I'm fine.
I'm glad to hear that. Oh, and Vanille was looking well. Don't you think so?
Hope, is it me or do you sound happy? Does someone have a little crush?
What are you talking about, Light? Of course not.
The Shadow Hunter was a
I'd like to meet the beautiful woman that's said to have solved the case.
Got in my way.
We're atoning for something. Apparently, it's a real antique of a thing. I wonder where they found it.
Still spreading cheer through the world after all these centuries. Wait till you see what I have in store for our world.
Passengers wishing to travel to the wildlands or dead dunes should board trains departing from the south.
Are you taking the train? Here for the train?
Nothing but the
welcome.
Please come again.
Why don't we go work with the volunteers who are trying to make Usnon better? We can make dreams come true for the whole city. Come on.
Ah, there you are. It didn't. Nothing happened, bad or good. Interesting. Very, very interesting. It appears that by mixing the poisons, rather than creating a new effect, they simply neutralized each other. Well, it was kind of refreshing, but the effect was pretty subtle. It didn't lift curses or cure wounds. Refreshing? That would suggest a positive influence on your state of mind, just as I anticipated. I still believe my theory is sound. It is a simple matter of tweaking the ratios of the recipe. I'll make another batch right now. You want me to test it again? Of course I do. An alchemist does not give up a truth because of one little setback. No, science must plow forward through stormy seas no matter what, and you will join me on this journey of discovery. There, my new and improved concoction. I believe it will be especially effective in curing the effects of poison. Nectar Mark II. Use it in your next battle and then return and tell me how wonderful it is. Oh dear, you are carrying a lot of things, aren't you? Maybe you should discard some of them. Do come again. Nectar Mark.
The lists are closed. The sands already soaked with blood. Come back tomorrow.
There you are. Welcome home. What's wrong?
Nothing, just things on my mind. Don't worry about it.
I can't help but worry. We're finally getting the chance to talk, but you don't seem happy. It's like you don't even know how to smile anymore.
Right now, this is the best I can do. Not that I was ever good at it.
It's okay. I can make you smile again. You just have to go back to the days when the future still looked bright.
When was that?
Back before we made all those mistakes. Before we started messing around with gods and Falsi. thought it was our destiny to fight for the world and the future. But all those battles, all those struggles, they didn't mean anything in the end.
Was it all a mistake? Even the journey you went on with Mel?
Well, what else would you call it? We risked everything, but in the end, we couldn't save the future, and I died. If that's not a mistake, what is? That's why I have to get rid of it. Throw it all away. It didn't mean a thing. It's done and gone. No regrets, just a clean slate. We're going to have a new world, and you and I will be just like we used to be way back when.
Listen, Sarah. Let me say this. If that journey was a mistake, I'm the one who has to bear the blame, because I sent you. It's me who has to pay the price. All you did was try your best. There's nothing wrong with that. It didn't turn out like I'd hoped, but it wasn't a mistake. You tried to do something that was good and right. You must never throw that away.
Maybe. But I don't want to remember it again. I just want to forget it all.
Right. When she said that, I didn't believe her. She'd always been able to accept hardship, fight through it, and be stronger for it. Lumina's words came back to me. She said, "The only fake I know is Sarah." No, that couldn't be right. The problem was in me, making me doubt her. But it was no good. The terrible thought had formed in my mind. The seed was planted. What if this Sarah was fake? And my memories of her, too. Give us a reprieve so that I can save more souls.
Good to see you again. So Vanille seems well. I'm glad. I remember her, you know, from way back when. Vanille and Fang turned into a giant crystal pillar. And together they held up an entire world. We were all supposed to be in it together, but in the end, the entire burden fell on their shoulders. So you see, they have to be helped. We don't have any choice. We owe them.
I saw her again. My sister. It looks like God might keep his promise and bring my sister back. She'll be a new Sarah.
New? What do you mean by that? Are you saying that when he resurrects Sarah, it will be a different person? Like a fake?
No, that's not it at all. I just mean, if she's going to be born again, she'll be a new version of her old self.
I don't think you're being straight with me, are you? You don't think the Sarah you met is the real thing, do you? You think that there's something missing. It's all right. You don't have to say anything. The truth is plain enough to see. Since I came here, I haven't been good at reading people, but I've been practicing on you. But don't worry, I'm on your side. Yours and Sarah's. You know that, right? You only agreed to become the savior because it was your only chance to save Sarah. And that means God has a hold on you. But if the Sarah he's showing you isn't real, then that control he has disappears. He has no hostage. You look like you've seen a ghost or something. Are you all right? there are certain areas within Nova Chrysalia that I want you to focus on. 5 locations where I'm picking up anomalous chaos readings.
And I'm guessing one of those locations is right where Snow is.
Yes, exactly. The palace in the city of Usnan. There is another spot, in the heart of Luxarian, the holy city. One more in the scorching sands of the Dead Dunes. And finally, I've measured large chaos fluctuations at 2 locations in the Wildlands.
4 regions, 5 locations.
To be more precise, the goals are people, not places. For example, the chaos activity in and around Snow's palace is linked to him, and the darkness in his heart. It's the same kind of chaos that I'm picking up in the other 4 locations.
And you want me to find these 5 people?
They're your priority, yes. Those people have massive burdens on them. The fate of many rests on their shoulders, and that makes your task all the harder. Helping them will not be easy, even for God's handpicked savior. But I can help you. The world is growing dangerously weak. You have to offer more Aradia to Yggdrasil. If you don't, the world will be destroyed. It'll be all over tomorrow. You have until 6 in the morning. Try to collect as much Aradia as you can by then.
Welcome to our village. Arius is its name, and it's home to the finest sheep in the Wildlands. You haven't heard of our sheep? Well, that's all right, I suppose. Not everyone has. If there's anything you want to know, about sheep or otherwise, you just ask me. Except, I charge a fee for every question. But I guess I could offer you a special deal. 1,000,000 gil. How does that sound? If you don't like it, then scram! It's a joke, sweetie. I do it to all our visitors. It makes them feel like part of the Arius family.
Do you know about our Dr. Sheep? He's the Wildlands resident expert on fuzzy sheep. Have you tried our sheep dishes? They're great! You'll leave with a smile.
Wait, wait! Oh, blast your fuzzy hides! Where are you going? Come back, please! This is a calamity! What shall I do? What shall I do?
Having some trouble?
Trouble? I'd say some of my flock has fled! They've never done this before. What set them off? And of all the times for it to happen, a disaster, I say.
Let me get this straight. It's my fault your sheep ran off, and so it's my job to bring them back?
Well, I realize you meant no harm, of course, but yes, if you're volunteering, please bring my sheep back.
Well, what do they look like?
3 in total, and you'll know them when you see them. They were raised on my own patented formula and grow much larger than normal sheep. It will be a simple matter to give them a scare and drive them back home where they belong. Do this for me and I will be most grateful, and I will offer you a special reward as thanks.
I'll look forward to it.
You should, because it will be in the form of my world-famous fuzzy sheep milk.
It's no ordinary milk, let me tell you. Packed with nutrients, creamy and delightful it is. And with 3 sheep, there'll be a lot of it.
That's the last of them.
On behalf of my sheep, I thank you. As promised, I present you with my sheep milk, the likes of which you won't find anywhere else. Just have to milk them. Hang on. There you go. Go on, take it. It's all for you. I tell you, if you hadn't found them, it would have been years of research down the drain.
Okay, so you're a scientist then, not just a sheep farmer?
Yes, exactly. Sheep's milk. That's my specialty. I carefully selected wild specimens and bred them for generations. I fed them a special formula I've refined over the decades, caring for them night and day. At long last, I had the fine, creamy milk I sought. And now I have the inestimable honor presenting the fruit of my labor to you, the one chosen by the Angel of Valhalla.
Chosen by the Angel, huh? So, what makes you think that's me?
Oh, I can put two and two together easily enough. The reports of a white chocobo, the growing tide of chaos and monsters, all are clear signs that the end of the world is upon us. Not only that, amidst all the portents, I hear rumors of a young woman warrior with rose-colored hair, a description that matches that of the white chocobo's master in some of the tales, and just as I was pondering that, you show up. Why, it had to be destiny!
It could be a lot of things, but you believe what you want.
Oh, I will! I have long known that the milk I made here would change the fate of the world. You are the one chosen by the angel. You change the world with every encounter, with every decision. Our meeting here was no accident.
Why don't you try feeding some of of that to the chocobo.
Such a resilient animal.
Will he be all right?
Let's have a look. Yes, he's doing much better. Healthy enough to be ridden, I'd say. He's on the way to a complete recovery, but you'll need to keep an eye on him for a while. I must say, he truly is a splendid specimen. I've spent 100 years caring for chocobos, and I feel as if it were all preparing me for this moment. Thank you.
Thank you. North of here lies a desolate land that's littered with the hulks of downed airships. Hardly anyone goes there, apart from the curious and the brave. If you manage to trek across that land, you'll eventually reach one particular airship wreck. There's a man who lives in that wreckage, a recluse who's turned his back on the rest of human society. Of course, he's not the only recluse to make his way out to the wildlands, but this one stands out with his giant nest of a haircut. I hear he used to be a pilot back in the day.
Thank you.
know there's a weird fellow who lives in the remains of that downed airship?